Very good afternoon to everybody. I'm so happy to be at this Food Eat Forum. We were in the middle of 2016, and last year, the world had two important global agreements, SDG in September and the Climate Agreement in December. Those two agreements clearly recognized the health of global commons, our ocean, our land, forest, water, and of course climate system are fundamental for the future of our people and planet. We have pushed our planet system to its limit. Now is the time to change the course. And this session is significant because this will bring two important global systems together, city system and food system. Let's talk about food system first. Food system, as currently it is, has put a lot of pressure on global environment. I will give you three numbers. Currently, 25% of GHG emission comes from food system. 80% of loss of tropical forest is caused by three global commodities, palm oil, soy, and beef. 70% of water is used for agriculture production. If we are going to be 9.6 billion in population by 2050, with 3 billion middle class, how we can feed these people while keep the planet as safe? We need a transformation of the food system. Without that, there is no sustainable future and no sustainable planet. I am so pleased and excited talking with this session with mayors. For the last few years, I have witnessed a strong leadership exercised by mayors. I am one of the luckiest guys who were present at local leaders summit, which took place in Paris during the COP climate negotiation. I was so moved to directly hear from 700 mayors, their leadership, their commitment, determination, and courage to take on this huge challenge of fight against climate change. I'm also very pleased to learn they are so willing, genuinely willing, to learn from each other what works and what doesn't work. And once mayors do come together collectively, there is a movement at the global scale. And that's why my institution, Global Environment Facility, has launched Sustainable City Program with other partners to help mayors' effort to fight against the global challenge, including climate change. I'm so pleased to note after mayors, Mark Watts, representing C40, talks that he is one of our partners to help mayors' effort to fight against global challenges. Now, let's think about how cities, the mayors, can help transform the food system. I can think of three potential areas that mayors, cities can help us. Number one, urban planning. As you may know, more than 10% of carbon footprint from food system comes from the distribution. So it's so significant for cities to have a compact, connected urban design, efficient transport and logistics, particularly in rapidly growing cities in developing countries. As you may know, 70% of the cities in India is yet to be built. We talk about potential of urban agriculture, but potential of this urban agriculture is to be realized. Zoning and regulation are so critical, where the mayors do have a significant role. The second area I think the cities can help the food system is waste management. 70% of solid waste is about food. So there is a huge room for mayors, cities can help transform the food system. I may want to give you one example, concrete example, which is very close to my heart. And there is also the local action can have a significant impact at the global scale. It's plastic in the ocean. As of today, 8 million tons of plastic is going to the ocean. If we continue as business as usual, by 2025, we have 1 ton of plastic per 3 ton of fish. How we could arrest this situation? Well, we need to work with mayors, work with the business to make a coalition to arrest this trend. Third area, I think, that then where the mayor cities can help the food system is behavioral change. Previous speakers in the session talk a lot about how we can change the behavior of consumers, behavior of the business. I think that then I noticed that then a lot of initiative already taking place at city level, but it's so important if we really want to change transform the food system, we need to find a way to influence and encourage the behavior of consumers. Quick three example, I found it very encouraging at city level. Public procurement of food could have a significant impact. School lunch can have a big influence over the future generation. Then how to deal with this food loss. As you may know, 1/3 of the food is wasted, produced but without being eaten. So again, city can encourage the people's movement to how to deal with those behavior. I have a huge hope that then you can do much better. So this is what I believe. We need a food. Food is healthier to the people and healthier to the planet. And this is my deep conviction that working together with cities and business, we can collectively change the way the food is produced, eaten, and disposed. And we need to work together and let us take the change, transformational change, to the food system. Thank you so much.